Tell you something else. There's a lot to be said for making people laugh. Did you know that's all some people have? It isn't much, but it's better than nothing in this cockeyed caravan.
The next comic is probably the sickest fuck you'll see tonight, and I love him for it.
That's one of my favorites. He is a man who is a Shaolin master of the dark arts. Ladies and gentlemen, the dark master.
This guy's one of my personal favorites. He's very warm, very lovable, very sweet, very giving. A guy who's been one of my friends since I started out of this business, and he consistently brings something new to the table every fucking week. You gotta admire that kind of dedication.
He's a man who has never been to anything that doesn't. He's one of my favorites. Give him up. Come on. Give him.
Guys, this next comedian, are you into clean comedy, squeaky clean?
This guy also helped me get kicked out of another venue that I was
at. That's one of the more interesting comedy podcasts in the area. JoshCast, check it out sometime.
The best show on the internet, Mr. Motherfucking Josh Jack Boo!
Jack Jack the social media
Jack
Oh no!
Jack
Hey, welcome to the show, everybody. One or two people listen to us if I'm lucky. How you doing out there? Welcome to the show. I already said that. Awful intro. My unemployment ran out. This is news for me and my life. My life is already in the shitter. As I'll be turning, the time you hear this podcast, I'll be 30 years old. My birthday is July 29th, Friday. I'll be turning 30. I live in my parents' basement. And it's Tuesday night here, by the way. And they said my unemployment was supposed to go to December of this year. Well, they only gave me 26 weeks. I tried to fill it out. I called in yesterday to the unemployment office, and they told me that that's it. There's zero left. 0.0. So I'm out of income. And I only got a couple thousand in the bank. How am I going to pay my car? Well, we're going to talk about this in future episodes, but let's get to the topical news. Tomorrow night, most likely, I'll be at the Crooked Eye Brewery in Hat Barrel. The last couple times I've been there, Andy Burbick, who's been on the show, him and I have been getting some drinks in the back of the cabaret, so maybe we'll do that. But let's see what's going on in the topical news, as we know that Hillary Clinton and a lot of people are in Philly, Bill Clinton, of course, and Trump, and everybody. That's right. A lot of people have been talking about everything, making jokes. Also, Miss Cleo died today, and a lot of people made the same hacky joke of, "Whoa, I didn't see. I don't know if she saw that coming." And it's really sad how, you know, I'm not a brilliant joke writer, sometimes you just look at people what they write and go, really? Rihanna says no Pokemon Go at her concert. It's insulting to her. She's up there shaking her pussy in your face, and you're busy playing Pokemon Go. That's not nice. Alarm and surveillance video shows man that he easily bypassed the TSA. So it's that easy to bring a gun in here, folks. It's that easy. A lot of people. Man faces 5 years in jail for a Seinfeld-inspired scheme. Oh, I gotta read this. Anthony Cumia's gotta be talking about this. Anthony Cumia. A Michigan man is facing up to 5 years in prison for allegedly trying to deposit 10,000 cans. Because Kramer and Newman tried to do it. Old episode of Seinfeld. He tried to bring them out of state to Michigan to get 10 cents per bottle. Oh my god, I can't wait for Cumia to do this story. Because he's a huge Seinfeld advocate. He talks about it almost every episode. That's hilarious. I love when people just watch an episode. One crucial word was never said in 61 speeches. Oh, terrorism. No one mentioned terrorism at all. I think with Michelle Obama, she might have done that. Obviously, she's pro-Hillary. Why would she be? We got to get the first cunt president. A heartbroken mother finds her boyfriend murdered in a backyard. That will break your heart, and also your vagina as well. A woman blasts an airline after she finds a revolting, what did she find? Oh, a pee luggage. I think I read this story before. If not, that's a trend that people have been peeing in people's luggages. Michael Lohan threatens Lindsay's fiance after a fight. Those Lohans are always up to something. Eddie Murphy's daughter totally outshines him at a movie premiere. Poor Eddie Murphy. What happened to this guy? He's like the funniest person on the planet. Mariah's fiance caught groping her on a dance floor. Okay. Well, I think he's supposed to do that. Alright. LeBron James donates $41 million. Yeah, if you got $41 million to donate, that means you have lots and lots and lots more money. My God. And speaking of money, I'm always out of money. If you'd like to donate any money to the show, if you'd like to donate a dollar, contact me on Facebook. If I can get a dollar, I can get $1 million by the end of this year. All right, because I get 1 million listeners. All right, folks. So once again, tomorrow I'll be at the Crooked Eye Brewery. If I get any coverage, maybe some Jack and Goat segment. A lot of people love those. Or maybe some podcast coverage with Andy Burbick or somebody. If not, it'll be another Plain Jane episode. It's the birthday show. Yay. Happy birthday, loser. 30 in the basement. Now you're out of income. Get a job. Yeah. Keep listening to find out what happens next. It's your favorite podcast show you don't listen to. It's JoshCast.
Hello?
Yes. Can I speak to Francis, please?
Speaking.
Hi, Francis. How you doing?
Yeah, good.
My name is Mark Timothy. I'm calling back from the call you gave me last Tuesday. Regarding to the hand job.
The what?
You gave me a call last Tuesday.
Concerning?
A hand job.
I don't have the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Well, your name's Francis Sorrentino or something like that, right? I don't know how to pronounce your last name.
Sorrentino.
Yeah, and someone gave me, well, I don't know if it was you or maybe someone's playing a joke, but, you know, they gave me the number and the name, you know, last Tuesday, told you to call you back as soon as possible for regarding to a hand job.
Still don't know what you're talking about.
A hand job.
Yeah, I know what a hand job is.
Yeah, but why would you call for that?
No.
So obviously someone's playing a joke.
Yeah, it sounds that way.
Why? I don't know. Someone just, I had a voicemail, you know, on my answer machine, because we weren't open last Tuesday. And the person said the name and the number, and then he said they needed the hand job really bad. Now, I don't understand.
Well, neither do I.
It's kind of weird. And you know what's even weirder? Me and you having a conversation about a hand job.
Uh-huh.
That's even weirder.
Yeah, and then if you stay on the line long enough, the police will have your number.
What?
If you stay on the line long enough, the police will have your number.
The police aren't just going to tap magically through your phone.
No, but I've been getting a lot of strange calls, so...
Have you been getting a lot of strange calls?
Yeah.
Well, what have they been doing?
Nothing, just yakking.
Yeah, what are they yakking about? I want to know.
Hey, you're not the only asshole in the world.
Why am I an asshole? You don't want to leave me voicemails about a hand job.
No, I didn't, and if you can prove that, go ahead.
I don't have the tape right now. But why the hell would I get you? Why the hell would someone leave me your number? What do you think? I just called random people in the phone book asking about hand jobs?
Yeah.
No, I don't. Mm-hmm. That is really ridiculous.
Well, I mean, you're not well, so why else would you be calling?
I'm not well.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? Look, do you want the hand job or not?
How much you going to pay me for it?
No, you pay us.
Oh, no, don't work that way.
Yeah, it does.
When I deal with assholes, they pay me.
Why do you have to keep referring me as an asshole, sir?
Yeah, and what else are you?
Well, I'm a really kind person. We just run a business here.
Yeah.
Well, you're a really dirty guy. You're just trying to call me an asshole. Ain't gonna make you feel better and, you know, make stuff like that.
Go ahead, keep talking.
Why? The police gonna trace my number?
Huh?
Do you actually think...
Your number's easy. I'll just dial *69.
No, my number's automatically blocked.
Not once the telephone company is aware of what's going on.
No, they're not, because people call it on me all the time.
Uh-huh. Oh, so you do call all the time?
No, I mean, some people threaten me. Some people, this happens sometimes. This happens sometimes, and when I tell people that about a hand job or a BJ, they threaten to call the cops on me all the time. But there's nothing the phone company can really do about that, because it's just a big misunderstanding, sir.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, well, I guess you're the one who's misunderstanding it.
I'm not misunderstanding anything. Someone left me a voicemail with a name and a number. Uh-huh. I called, they referring to a hand job, and I don't understand. And now you're calling me an a-hole and all different types of names.
And my wife's getting tired, so I guess I'll have to let you go.
Have you got a wife? What do you need us for a hand job for?
Oh, I don't know. You might be willing to pay enough.
Shit, what is she, a stroke victim?
Huh?
What is she, a stroke victim? What's wrong with her?
I'm asking for trouble, boy.
Boy?
Yeah, boy.
Well, I'm not trying to disrespect...
Why are you a girl instead? You poor little thing. You need a boy to take care of you.
Well, I'm not trying to disrespect your wife, sir. I'm just saying...
Yeah?
How's Sunday... How's next Sunday sound?
You got the money, I got the time.
No, you're paying, sir.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
You can't get pleasure and pay for it.
Huh?
You can't get pleasure and pay for
it. What makes you think anybody having an affair with you would be pleasure?
No, not with me. My clients. I'm just the guy that does the calls. I didn't say nothing about me giving a hand job.
Couldn't even keep my dog happy.
Why would I want to jerk you? Why would I want to jerk your dog off? I'm not your family.
Hey, Thursday night here, / almost Friday morning. Happy birthday to me! Yay, that's right, who gives a shit? That's right, I'm turning 30 years old, it's 11:46 p.m. And it's not that it matters. I went out for two drinks and two shitty Northeast bars. And, yeah man, I'm turning 30 years old, you know? I'm living in my parents' basement, I got no job, I got no income. Will Fitz, who I saw last night at the Hapro open mic, he said he's trying to get me a job at his funeral home. As you know, Will Fitz, he works in a funeral home, picking up corpses and such, and driving them from point A to point B, and it makes really good money, and I'm trying to do that. I'm trying to get a part-time job, possibly a full-time job there or something, because I have no income. But yeah, 30 years ago, my mother once told me, she asked me to lend her money, and I said no. And she said to me, the wrong son died. Because I had a brother that was born before me who was a miscarriage. And speaking of my cunt mother, this happened today. Even though my birthday's not till tomorrow, pretty much my mom and dad gave me some money for my birthday early. And then my mom starts crying today, like, oh, there's no food in the house, we got no food. So I gave her the money back. They do that every single year. They give me money, and then they take it back. So I said, here you go, take the money back. And she's like, no. I said, no, just take it. Just fucking take it. And I'm not paying the cable bill next month. She threw the cable bill on my downstairs on my couch thing. And I said, nope, I'm not paying it. Here you go, you take the money. Go. And they went out grocery shopping. So they didn't give me anything for my birthday. But you know what? I'm fine with that. Because all I really want is everyone to leave me alone. You know, you're a 30-year-old man who lives in your parents' basement. And you're a loser. You don't have a job, no income, and nobody wants to fuck you. You already feel bad enough. You just want to be left alone. So that's why I got liquored up tonight, and then tomorrow my sister and my brother-in-law are taking me out somewhere to eat. And I'm going to try to go to Atlantic City tomorrow for a few hours, so I'll tell you guys the next segment what happens. But enough of me yapping for 2 minutes about my shitty life. Let's get right over to the topical news. As last night, Andy Burbick, Will Fitz, John Rice, and I swung over to the Hapro open mic to the back of the Cabana Bar at the Cabaret and just had some drinks. It was a fun conversation. John Rice was screaming to the top of his lungs, and as he always is, and he forgot he had to do something, and skittish squirrels convinced a snack is hidden in a cat's furrows. I don't know why a squirrel is... Isn't a squirrel considered a endangered species? Wait, I gotta read this story. Car thieves accidentally become heroes, and it shows three black guys... Sorry, I just had two drinks of me. Thank goodness for these burglars. It may have been an accident, but four thieves have saved a dog's life at Chicago. And Chicago is black-on-black crime out the wazoo. I don't know if folks know that. And it says here in Chicago's West Town neighborhood, four men walking... Oh, it's four blacks. Security footage shows the group checking out a truck on the street. So they were checking out the truck so they can smash it. And they took a laptop and ran off. And it's a good thing the window was a story because it was a German Shepherd. So that's my whole point. They didn't care about the pit bull. They saw a laptop. They smashed the window and they saved the dog. They're still fucking assholes. They're still thieves. They're not heroes. Who cares about saving a dog? A laptop is more valuable these days than a fucking dog. You can tell I'm drunk right now, folks. Man kills girlfriend's disabled son after a gut-wrenching act. And this makes me sad, because I have someone in my family who's kind of mentally disabled, besides my mother. And if you look at this kid's face, his nose is smashed. Not from the punch, but he's born this way. He has no ears. His man sentenced to 3 years in prison for putting vodka in girlfriend's disabled son's feeding tube. Oh, so he didn't kill. Wait a minute, I thought it said he killed. Yeah, man kills girlfriend's disabled son. He only got 3 years for that? Wait a minute, if you kill a disabled kid, you only get 3 years? Are you serious? Those blacks that stole the laptop probably got 2 days. Might as well reward them. Give them a fat white girl. Whole Foods is slammed over a contentious slogan. World's healthiest slogan was rejected. What was it? The agent called the phrase, world's healthiest grocery store. So yeah, they try to praise itself, and they were like, no, you're not. A 7-year-old girl was accidentally killed while posing a photo at the zoo. I did a bit of my act about how I think it's funny how people who pose for selfies die because they're idiots. But a 7-year-old girl, I mean, that's a kid, though. That's not like a grown person being an asshole. I'm not going to laugh and make fun of that story, but, you know, what are you going to do? Restaurant secret to reheated pizza surfaces online, and it's got to be one of those big pizza chains like Domino's, Leftover Pizza, The Reddit, Here's What to Do. Oh, I thought it was a fast food chain. Who gives a shit? Who doesn't? If you don't know how to reheat pizza, you're a fucking idiot. I have a toaster oven, and I put it in there on 450 degrees for a few minutes, and it tastes absolutely delicious. Anybody can heat up pizza. You can heat it in a frying pan, in an oven, in a microwave, in a toaster oven. Sesame Street fires 3 characters after 45 years. Was it a controversy? One of them had AIDS or something? Scruff McRuff? Alright, so that's not it for this segment. On the next segment, I'll talk about what happened on my shitty birthday, my big 30th birthday. I've lived in the parents' basement, and you know, possible sober drunk commentary. I'm going to try to get drunk Saturday night and get some sober, actually drunk commentary with sober people, possibly. And, you know, anything else that happens, you're going to hear it here, folks. It's the birthday episode. Pretty much a Lane Jane episode. And also, I forgot to mention this, Brian Lichter, B. Lion, was at the Happer open mic last night. He signed up as Mr. Comedy, which is pretty funny, and did a regular set. We might be shooting more pranks this coming Monday. I don't know. I think he canceled today. I'm not sure. But hopefully soon. So more updates on that. Keep listening.
This is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. I'm Josh cause I'm fly. You ain't cause you not. I'm Josh cause I'm fly. You ain't cause you not. This is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh. I'm Josh cause I'm Josh. Actually, my name's Josh. When I came out my mom's twat, when I was first born, I was kicking and screaming. They said, oh, he's an angel. Really, I'm a demon. Now I'm popping off semen like it's fireworks. People can't stand me cause I'm on fire jerks. One of the best. I'm a prank call master. I'm sick of slow fuck, so I talk a little faster. Doing stupid songs and turning the fire bangers. Fucking up bitches with wire hangers. I use a sharp point to fuck up those pussy lips. I make you walk funny, so don't push me, bitch. Yeah, I'm never classy, don't make me get nasty. Whisper would rape your bitch, the girls will walk right past me. And when she starts to panic and starts to run fast, I tell her to slow down so I can find my rapist mask. This is why I'm Josh, this is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh, this is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. I'm Josh cause I'm fly, you ain't cause you not. I'm Josh cause I'm fly, you ain't cause you not. This is why I'm Josh, this is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. Only 20 years old, I got 9 CDs. Of my own materials, you ain't fuck with me.
too much spare time, jerking away my mind. I can't even think, I think I'm out of line. I don't take shit and I don't give a fuck. Making threats to bitches, calling them cunts. I ain't slapped that bitch, I just barely tapped her. I bash cunts so much I call myself the cunt basher. It's just a nickname, so don't even worry. Know I'm big and bad, but that don't make me scurry. Bitch, get on Murray, you are not the father. You got some baby daddies, so I ain't gonna bother. Stupid ass bitches, I'ma have to bomb them. Dirty ass pussy must be allergic to condoms. This is why I'm Josh, I just got issues. Destroying the rainforest by coming in tissues. This is why I'm Josh, this is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. This is why I'm Josh, this is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh. I'm Josh cause I'm fly, you ain't cause you not. I'm Josh cause I'm fly, you ain't cause you not. This is why I'm Josh, this is why I'm Josh. This is why, this is why, this is why I'm Josh.
Hey, Saturday night here, and last night, my sister and my brother-in-law took me out to this place called Las Margaritas here in the Northeast on Welsh and the Boulevard, and it was like Taco Bell, but a little bit better, but I didn't care. I had a big margarita with it, got a little tipsy, and then I'm surprised I didn't take a shit last night, because I had some a portion of overloaded nachos. I had chips and salsa before the meal. I had a soft chicken taco with a little bit of rice, and I had a burrito. I ate all this food, and I don't know how I didn't shit, but I didn't. Then I went down to Columbus Boulevard. I went to Morgan's Pier. The volume was actually perfect. There wasn't a lot of people there. I had some Jägermeister, got a little tipsy. And it's Saturday night here, folks, and I think I'm going to hang out in Old City tonight. I'm not sure, because either way, I'm going to get some sober, drunk commentary, which I usually get. The big story is 16 people have died in a Texas hot air balloon crash. So I guess there wasn't enough air inside the balloon. Okay. I'm not going to make jokes about that. Because, you know, that's sad. Because, it's like, imagine if you want to do something fun and then you die. That's just... actually, speaking of that, I had a dream yesterday that I died. I was driving my car, and I tried to park it on top of this pier, and it crashed, and I drowned. Yeah, that really happened yesterday. I had a dream of my 30th birthday, everybody, that I died. Another celebrity turned down millions so they can play at the RNC. Nick Jonas! And the more surprising news is Nick Jonas is actually getting paid millions to perform. I didn't even think that guy was still in show business. Woman reportedly arrested for riding bicycles in public. What was she, nude? More in this story. Oh, it's an Iranian woman. And afterwards, they stoned her to death. Because isn't that what they do down there, folks? Alright. One university will now let you catch Pokemon Go for credit. Can you imagine a university as a class? I like universities to have, like, classes like that, like Pokemon Go or, you know, media classes and stuff. You get to watch TV and stuff. That's awesome. That's fun stuff. Never had that in community college. Visits to Safari Park turns deadly after a woman leaves a car. And let's see what happened here. Chinese woman was killed by a tiger in an animal park. So, yeah, that sounds like to me it definitely turned deadly. Angel star pay homage to Big Poppy in a funny way. A lot of stories about Trump and backlash and things he has said, and Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders, and everybody's talking about it on my Facebook because everyone knows everything about politics. Bikini clad cop tackles and arrests a pickpocketed man, and it's a female officer with a ripped body. A Swedish cop. Oh, this is in Sweden. Don't mess with a girl in a bikini. So, she just, that's the best way to get it. At least it's not a guy's knee in your ass. It's a girl's knee in your ass, which is still kind of gay, but at least, you know, it's a girl. If a girl's knee goes in your ass, is that gay? Is the question of the story of this podcast. Okay, so there's no other news I could talk about right now. There's not much really going on. I'm going to try my best to get sober drone commentary. I usually get it 90% of the time, unless it starts raining really hard or something like that. Who knows? I might just be super tired or anything can happen. Then I will not recover. Sometimes I'm just not in the mood. There's nothing going on. Sometimes it's just really dead, especially here in the summer. But if so, you will hear it after this clip. And if not, either way, I'll be wrapping this episode up with odd and topical news, folks. Another Lane Jane playing episode in the books for the birthday show. Keep listening.
All right, it's Old City, 1:55 a.m., sober drunk commentary, Saturday night, and some stupid cunt with dreads is playing an awful music song. And I got down here at 11:40. I stopped by the Northeast Comedy Cabaret, which I don't really do on a Saturday, but because it was raining, and I decided, I knew tonight was going to be like one of those dull nights. I said, why get up here early? So, went to the Northeast Cabaret to hang out with John Rice, Andy Burbeck, Timmy Lai, and a couple other people I knew there. Will Fitz did not show up. And I hung out a little bit. I had two beers. And then I swung over down here to Old City. And nothing really happened. I went to a couple bars. I usually record this right at 2 a.m., but I'm doing this early because that way I can leave a little earlier. I see a couple people down here I know, but I didn't really approach them or anything. I'd like to go out and do my own thing, you know, because this is a drag just to hang out with certain people, you know. I'm outside the Plow in the Stars right now. It's like the only place where all the action's at. Volume down here is not that good, but I think it's a little bit more busier because of the rain, because the outdoor bars, you know, once they got outside in the fucking rain, I mean, it's fun, but I don't know about partying outside in the rain. This one guy, he was like lit, he was like really drunk, and he would try to go inside this bar, and the bouncer just kept pushing him, so the bouncer just pushes him in the street. This guy was lucky he didn't get hit by a fucking car. If there was a car came by, he would have got smashed. That happened. Other than that, that's all I had. I had a slice of pizza, so my ass is all greasy right now. Especially after last night when I had all that fucking Mexican food. My God. So yeah. That was pretty much my night. Just going from bar to bar. Pretty lame, I know. And now, once again, the street harassment has not happened. But give it about... give it about 6 or 7 minutes. Not too wild out here. Did see a couple people throw up, but I think that's every night in Old City. Alright, I'm trying to get away from the loudness over here. We're back over here to the Plow. Well, I don't mind some loud background noise. It does add to the setting. But sometimes it's just really fucking annoying. Could have went inside the Cuba Libre tonight, but I didn't feel like it. I didn't feel like dropping $10 because I'm cheap. Plus, I already spent $10 for beer anyways at the cabaret, so. And with the slice of pizza, I'm up to 15. That's enough for a night out. I mean, 15 bucks. Even though I got some birthday money, that's enough, man. I'm not here to spend all that much. Okay, out come the hoes. Three hoes across the street wearing black dresses, taking selfies, walking like they want to get fucked. Then I guarantee a guy will come up to them. That's what they want. That's what they go out for. There's no other reason. Bunch of hoes. I'm glad I really don't approach anymore. Even though my dick is dead, I'm glad I don't do it anymore. Because it's just, it gets tiring. You know? Yeah, so yesterday I turned 30, and I'm nine years too old to be hanging out down here, I guess you could say. But some people do come out here in their 40s and 50s and 60s and shit, so I guess that doesn't matter. Alright, so now that some of the loud people have left, now I'm going to go back on this side now. try to go back and forth and try to get away from certain people.
I feel like some people, it's like, it's weird. It's like people drink and then they don't care because their judgment's lowered. And because they don't care, they just like sit right next to you. They like stare right next to you and just start talking, you know. Like this random guy just, he gave me a high five. He said, dude, what's up? Dude. I gave this random chick a fist bump. Wow, that was cool. Should have said something. I gave this random chick a fist bump. That's the only approach I've made tonight. Like I said, once the action does happen, I usually record this outside Cuba Libre Blue Martini. I think I'm going to head over there now because I'm getting tired of this seat over here. There's this really loud black guy. He won't shut the fuck up. You're just being stupid. He's got to give me a headache. Trying to get away from this guy. Alright, across the street now. Now I'm going to head over to the Blue Martini, Cuba Libre's. I used to record. I try to record different places, but God. I just stand, you know, the whole being loud thing. Like, oh, I'm drunk, I'm being loud. But can you shut the fuck up, though? A little bit? 6 minutes into recording, it's 2:01 now. Officially 2:01. That means the street harassment is getting ready to happen, baby. It's all going down here. Alright, I'm walking behind the Blue Martini. Now we're in Cuba Libre's. Right now outside the Cuba Libre's. Cuba Libre's. And I don't know, seeing people come out doesn't look that good. But then again, some people do leave early. As I said, I don't think it's worth $10. Especially here in the summer, I don't think it's worth it. It's not worth it. Don't feel like putting dress shoes on. Don't feel like putting fucking dress shoes on and paying $10. All these hoes now complaining about their stinking ass feet hurting. I think I give a goddamn your stinking ass feet hurt, bitch. Take your shoes off and gum me. Man, I'm getting too old for this shit. I really am. Same old, same old. I feel like the sober drunk commentary segment is just getting old. Maybe I should stop recording it. I mean, no one listens to this show anyways. And it seems like nothing, even though I describe what's going on, you can't see it. Oh yeah, today I took my video camera and I put it inside this case. It was like this little lavender case that came with my bed sheets, and I made a hidden camera out of it. I cut a hole right out of it. So I should just bring my camera out here and try to get like hidden camera stuff, you know what I'm saying? Because maybe it'd be better if you could see what I'm saying, but I don't know if I want to do that or not. Because eventually someone's going to notice it's a camera. People aren't stupid. You know? Not much action's really going on. You know, people are getting their cabs and their pizzas and their cheesesteaks and their Ubers and stuff. All different types of stuff. But that's just, yeah, Dock Street is around there. You can find it. Two stinking hoes just walked past me. Another two stinking hoes. There's some hoes in the south. There's some hoes in the south. There's some hoes. As far as drinking goes, I had 2 beers tonight. Not enough last night. I had Jägermeister. And I had a margarita. So tonight I really didn't drink compared to last night. Because I had, you know, 2 beers. 2 beers is nothing. I mean, unless your tolerance level's that low, they got two beers, you know what I mean? So, it's pretty much nothing. Didn't do anything for me. And I'm recording right now as people are walking almost into me. It's a test. I'm not going to sit here and move. I'm going to stand right here at the corner. I'm standing right outside the Cuba Libre. Not right outside, a little bit away from it. And I'm just trying to get out of people's way, but people still walk near me because they're drunk. So there's something about it. There's something about people, they drink and they just walk right next to you. I don't get why they do that shit. I say, don't even give a fuck, but... Yeah. But I'm going to record for probably a few more minutes and then I'm going to fucking get out of here because it's not much going on. These two hoes are just fucking sitting right at the end of the corner. Many guys have approached them. That's what happens with these fucking hoes, man. They need so much goddamn attention. This one guy approached them. He's coming back now. These guys are so thirsty. It's not going to happen. All these fucking hoes. Oh, there's more coming. Doesn't matter, though. But I had, I got here 11:40. I could have got here... Could have got here earlier.
Oh my God.
But I didn't. Now I got three loud hoes in front of me now. I got no respect, pretty much. I got no respect, and I'm gonna fucking give it to her. You know? One actually just turned around and looked at me. Like, no one's even talking to you. I'm having a conversation with somebody. Trying to have a conversation with somebody, and then people would just look at me like I'm talking to them. No one's talking to me. Mind your business. I'm talking to who I'm talking to, and I don't want to hear anything. Okay? I don't want to hear it. Because I'm talking to who I'm talking to. And even as I'm saying this right now, people are looking at me. And so that looks like I'm having... That's what I should do one night. I should have an argument, like... I should have an argument, like I'm having an argument with somebody, but I'm really not. You know what I'm saying? So... Not much is really happening. These three stinking hoes are fucking playing some sword fight shit. They got they give out these things free in the bar at the Cuba Libre. They look like lightsabers. And, these three hoes were just hitting each other with it. And then they had the nerve to turn around and look at me like I'm looking. It's like, no one wants to look at you. They always have to do that. You know, it's like, no one's looking at you. And of course, they had to go look at me. Now I got a homeless guy standing near me. That's not good. I think he heard me, but oh well. I was standing here first. So fuck them. Just tired of people, you know what I'm saying? It's the opposite. Try to get away from people, that people want to get near you. Whenever you want to get near people, nobody wants to be near you. So as you can see, it's some sort of psychological experiment. Yeah, so, I'm across from the Continental, but not a lot is, going on down here. I'm getting ready to head down a little bit. I'm almost 15 minutes into recording. I haven't said a goddamn interesting thing. But that's the story of my life, you know what I mean? I got down 11:40. And I should have got down here later, but I thought it'd be early enough, but I guess it wasn't. Should have got here later. But nobody wanted to hang out at the cabaret because, you know, at the place I was at, the cabaret, I was going to... Andy Burbick, who's done the show before, he was, like, upset that he didn't advance to the next round. He tried to play it off like, oh, I don't care. It doesn't bother me. But after the round was over, he was dramatized, you know? He fucking sat there against the wall and... You know, he was upset, you know? So I left. And then John Rice, he moved on to the next round, but, you know, I can't ask him to hang out because if I say, hey, Rice, you want to hang out? He always says, oh, my friend. Oh, my friend and I are going to do this. Oh,
my friend and I going to do that. So I didn't bother to, you know what I'm saying? I really didn't bother to ask him. You know what I'm saying? I didn't bother. Watch your cock box. Yeah, this girl gave me a stink look. She walked into me, though. She wanted to feel my penis. She wanted to feel my big, warm penis. But that's not my problem, though. It's starting to get dry mouth now. I think that's a sign I should wrap up. Alright, I'm going to move to a different location because this homeless guy now has a... They got a dog with them now. Uh-oh. More Rachi. More raunchy business going on. Notice how quiet it is down this street compared to the other one. Listen to the background noise. It's almost nothing compared to Market. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so I saw a couple pickup guys tonight. These guys who do pickup. I saw a couple of them. I don't acknowledge them. Some of these guys are guys I used to hang out with them. Some of them are new guys I've been introduced to. And I don't acknowledge them. I don't say hi to them. Just like sometimes when I go down, I see comedians. I see comedians that I know, and I don't really say hi to them sometimes, depending on who it is. Because they know who I am. They may not like me, but they know it's okay, that's Josh, but they don't, so I don't say nothing to them. Same way. But anyways, I've recorded now for 18 minutes. Nothing's gonna happen down here. I might not even put this up, but I probably will. Sober commentary with drunk people failed again. Alright, maybe next week will be better. Probably not.
Alright, so you just heard some very mediocre sober drunk commentary. It's Sunday night here, gonna wrap this episode up. And B Lion just texted me as I'm editing my sober drunk commentary, and he wants to shoot some videos tomorrow between 3 and 6. I'm not sure what's going to happen tomorrow. Hopefully I have a job interview. I'm trying to get this job, but we'll see what happens with that. Also, I'm thinking about updating the sober drunk commentary segment. I'm thinking about maybe next week just bringing my camera with me and just sitting across the street and bringing my inline recorder and maybe putting a visual to these, sober drunk commentary segments. Maybe just edit them. I don't know if that's going to work, but it's worth a shot. It's worth to try out the idea. I just upgraded my phone. As I said before, I now have a Samsung Galaxy J7, which is a cheap version of the S7, and it's pretty cool. I went to three T-Mobiles today just to get this phone, because I went to the first T-Mobile, and the cunt behind the counter, even though it wasn't her fault, said, "Our system's down, so we can't transfer you. You have to call customer service." I'm thinking, well, what is customer service going to do? Because customer service actually has to give me a SIM card. But I guarantee if I wanted to buy a phone, they would have said, oh, sure. Then I went to this other T-Mobile, and it said they didn't open till 11. So I went all the way down the boulevard, and then I saw this one T-Mobile was empty. I went inside. The guy helped me. He was very nice. And there you go. Same number. Not that anybody cares. And yeah, let's get to the, the fucking odd and topical news and wrap this thing up. I'm not sure if there's anything going on. One dead and two are missing after devastating Maryland floods. Ice cream truck driver speaks out after a brutal attack. Someone, I guess, pulled him out the car and whipped his ass. I guess he didn't put enough sprinkles on there. No? Nobody like that one? Alright. I'm bombing on my own podcast. Is that possible? Chipotle is trying to open up a burger place to make a big comeback, so it's going to be the same kind of diarrhea that happens in their burritos, just in burgers. Multi-racism scandals rock Miss Teen USA pageant, and behind this white lady, this blonde blue-eyed girl, it shows a black girl and a sort of Hispanic girl. So, I don't know. Is it racism that they picked the... Once again, if you're a white person, you can't win over a black person. I mean, let's just be honest, that's just racist. Famous face helps dying passenger in the middle of a flight. Tim Tebow. Tim Tebow really is an angel. He doesn't have sex with anybody, and he saves lives. Bruce Willis and Demi Moore's daughter poses topless. So that just goes to show you, when your parents break up and they're famous, you become a whore. Man fends off carjackers with an unusual weapon. This is from autoblog.com. With a pressure sprayer. So there's a video right here. How is this on video? This is in Louisiana. He was jumped by some carjackers while washing his car. He was thinking fast. They said, give me your keys and your money. And I said, what did you say? And I took the spray and I sprayed it right in his face. Nice. So that's justice. There's an NBA superstar who's humiliated by a mobile mistake. Draymond Green claims hijack on nude Snapchat picture. So this guy took a picture of his big black dick and somebody hijacked his phone. He shouldn't be ashamed. I mean, I guarantee he's packing. So if you're packing, don't worry about it. If he has a small black dick, well, I can understand how embarrassing he must be. Kid warns dad of a stinky surprise with a hilarious note. Oh my god, kids say the darndest things. Kid writes her dad a nice letter warning him of a stinky surprise. His mom's pussy. That says, dear dad, my room might not smell like I poop in the morning. I know that because I have diarrhea. And he put, if you don't understand soft poop, do not worry, I have a towel just in case. Love, Gracie. So that is kind of funny. Poop, diarrhea. He spelled diarrhea wrong. He's a kid. Diarrhea is not a, you know, a easy word to spell. And now let's get to the weird news, topical news. Let's get to that right now. My favorite segment to close the show out. The only segment to close the show out here. The JoshCast episode 206. Viral blackhead video is the grossest, most satisfying thing we've ever seen. This guy's picking blackheads with, like, pliers. DJ loses himself in Eminem lyrics to complain, and he gets a hilarious reply. So I'm an Eminem fan. He's my favorite artist. Let's see what they say. A DJ took serious inspiration from Eminem complaining to a British online store. This is from England. Oh, so he reworked the first verse of the rapper's hit Stand to try to find out what was happening with the blaze you want to exchange. I sent you my exchange, but it's still returning. He put, dear S's, I sent you my exchange, but it's still returning. Left my size, product code, and order number at the bottom. I said, a fuck blazer in July. You must have not have got him. The pie was the problem at the DMP post office or something. Sometimes the scribble gestures too sloppy when I jot him. But anyway, fuck it. What's been up, man? How's the market space? My wardrobe's looking bare too. I need to get my blazer. If I finally receive my blazer, guess what I'm gonna call her? I'm gonna name her Bonnie. I read about your website crash too. I'm sorry. I had a friend who went top man because he thought ASOS didn't want them. I know you probably hear this every day, but I'm your biggest fan. I got the ASOS original shit you did back in Jan. I got a wardrobe full of clothes and your shoes, man. I like the shit you did with Premier 2. That shit was bad. Anyways, hope you get this, man. Hit me back. Just a chat. Julio is the biggest fan. This is Jay. Ha! So that's fucking great. So I wonder if Eminem saw this. Look forward to who sued. Some people suggested would have been better. Looks like it worked. Some people suggested Rihanna would have been better off applying in Eminem lyrics. So yeah, I mean, that's funny. That's good. That's genius, actually. There's a 103-year-old ice cream man that melts your hearts. He melts ice cream too. Pokemon Go characters star in famous movies. So he's showing regular Pokemon people in various movies. Shetland pony breaks into a pub and starts drinking from beer glasses. That's fucking awesome. How can that happen to me when I'm drinking? It shows a pizza being pretty much on fire. I wonder if that's still good. Adorable toddler gets caught in a husky pool party. Hilarity ensues. Oh, she's with a bunch of little dogs and they're wearing masks. Woman claims sexual style assault by restaurant's pee-pee doll. So she felt sexually assaulted. It's kind of weird. There's a 340-year-old shipwrecked cheese and it looks burnt. I don't know why anybody would eat that unless you want to get sick. This guy keeps putting his middle finger up at his dog, and he's going ballistic. That's cute. A lot of Donald Trump news. I don't really want to talk about it. He's always in there. World's tallest water slide may be most frightening. It shows a guy with a GoPro cam, and he looks like he's dying in ice or something. Florida man has the world's greatest alias name ever. He said, I would beat every cop's ass. So, that's his alias. He's a white guy. Not a black guy. A white guy. Dennis shows off gruesome injuries after a shark attack in Bahamas. And he's lucky he's still alive. Good news is, his teeth still intact. So, it shows a solo polo tattoo. And it's on a woman's hiney. a very delicious hiney. I don't know why she's ruining that, but... Border Patrol agents detained two Pokemon Go players. They try to sneak over the border. Come on, man, you took my Pikachu! And Baltimore had its own kind of bulls. I read that story. Well, that's it for the show, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys on the next one. If anything happens with the B-Lion, the Brian Lichter segment, you'll hear about it on the next episode. And all that stuff. Keep listening. And I'll see you guys on the next one. It's JoshCast.
You have just listened to... The world's most awful podcast show. JoshCast.